Hello, I'm Kirby Chambliss.
Hi, I'm Jason Newberg.
I'm Matt Chapman.
I'm John Klatt.
Hi, I'm Larry Strain, Airshow narrator.
I fly the Red Bull Edge 540.
I fly the Pitts Viper.
I'm standing in front of my Eagle 580 Airshow airplane.
Flying the Air National Guard Stoddarker S-300.
And you're watching Live Airshow TV.
Live Airshow TV.
Live Airshow TV.
Live Airshow TV.
And you're watching Live Airshow TV.
As the 2011 airshow season draws to a close, a number of shows in the South take center stage. Many of those are in Florida and in Texas. Live Airshow TV was on hand at the 30th anniversary of the El Paso Amigo Airshow. It was packed full of great performances that thrilled a large crowd. The day got kicked off with the Paramania Power Gliders. Airshow announcer Larry Strain welcomed the crowd as the U.S. Army's Golden Knights jumped in to officially open the show. One of Live Airshow TV's cameras jumped in with the Golden Knights for a great perspective. After circling the jumpers, Rob Holland and Matt Chapman flew a duo routine against the clear blue skies.
It was great flying today here in sunny El Paso. No wind, 5-10 mile an hour winds, blue skies, great temperatures. Looks like a huge crowd, and it's still early in the morning.
It's beautiful, beautiful sky, beautiful crowd. It was nice and smooth. It's a great day for an air show. I look forward to doing my solo later on.
This show was jam-packed with great aerobatic performances, and up next was John Klatt in the Air Guard Extra 300. After greeting some of the fans and having a little fun,
can you wave to Live Airshow TV? Say Live Airshow TV is my favorite station. Tell me, okay?
Live Airshow TV is my favorite station.
Oh, yeah.
John talked with us about flying in El Paso.
Man, it was incredible. I mean, look at these skies. I look around, I can't see a cloud in the sky. You got the mountains behind us. I tell you what, this is what an air show is all about. We're right here at the epicenter of an American air show. It doesn't get any better than that. We have some of the best performers in the nation here, and I just had my 12 minutes of fame, and it was awesome.
Steve Lambrick showed the crowd some biplane action with his Boeing Stearman PT-17. Les Shockley brought out this super shock wave and got a race challenge from Tim Weber. Tim then took over the skies with his own brand of aerobatics choreographed to music that he wrote and performed.
Turn me loose and let me go fly.
Bob Carlton quieted things down for just a bit, showing his grace and beauty of aerobatics in his sailplane. This plane is a bit different because it has a small jet engine on top. This allows Bob to take off without a tow plane and also do several things that most sailplanes won't do. The U.S. Customs and Border Protection demonstrated how they use helicopters to help track and stop potential unlawful acts at or near the border. A fast rope insertion team showed how they deploy reinforcements to end the situation. The first of several military acts was the U.S. Air Force A-10 Thunderbolt II. Of course, it is also known as the Warthog because of its devastatingly good looks. But you can't argue with its maneuverability and firepower. Rob Holland returned in the afternoon for his solo routine that showed why he is the 2011 U.S. National Unlimited Aerobatics Champion.
This year I went to the World Aerobatic Championships and I won the freestyle competition. Then I went to the U.S. Nationals, and I'm now the 2011 U.S. National Aerobatic Champion. So it's been fun, it's been successful, and it's been a real challenge.
Then it was time for John Klatt, Bill Kearns, and Neil Darnell with the Air Guard's Max Adrenaline. A new group of fans discovered these guys following the Joint Service Open House back in May when Live Airshow TV posted clips from that show. They are even more exciting when the Flashfire jet truck has a full runway to work with.
John Klatt and I have been friends for my whole air show career, and he felt that he would like to have a jet truck in the act, and we've been talking about this for 4 or 5 years, and we finally last year got it put together.
Once the smoke cleared, the U.S. Army's Golden Knights returned for their full jump performance. The precision of these jumpers is amazing. Matt Chapman returned later in the afternoon for his solo performance. It's easy to see why he is one of the best in the business. Live Airshow TV talked with many of these performers and will have profiles on them during the airshow off-season. The show wrapped up with the U.S. Navy's Blue Angels and their transport plane, Fat Albert. Live Airshow TV was along for the ride back in 2009, and this is quite a ride for such a big plane. The six demonstration pilots then took to the air, showing their wingtip-to-wingtip precision. Larry Strain wrapped things up this way.
This was a great day. First time in 14 years that the Blue Angels have been here at El Paso, and we had a wonderful show at 10:30 this morning. 30 minutes before they started flying, we reported that the parking lot was totally full. So great show, great support by the people here.
That put a cap on the 30th anniversary of the El Paso Amigo Air Show. The crowds at Biggs Army Airfield were treated to some of the best performances in the business, as well as the return of the Blue Angels. The air show staff did a wonderful job, and we know they are already working on the 2012 show. From Biggs Army Airfield and the 30th anniversary of the El Paso Amigo Air Show, I'm Jeff Lee, Live Air Show TV.